Owning and operating a dance studio business is not like running a sandwich shop, but we do it because we love it and our work is important. So how do we simultaneously balance passion and profit? This is How to Survive Dance Studio Life with Tiffany Henderson and Amanda Scott. Even though I know the music is Tiffany's favorite. We are ready for fall, for changing leaves, buying new throw pillows, and our Thrive event. Our first stop is going to be in Dallas, and tickets are just going like hotcakes. We have a lot of owners, teachers, and administrators already signed up to join us November 14th and 15th. And we're going to have lots of new classes with timely topics. Our friends and partners at Revolution and Dance Studio Owner are also going to be there. And if you're still on the fence about, you know, whether or not those 2 days are worth your time, we have a webinar coming up. Tiffany, do you want to tell us a little bit about the webinar?
Absolutely, yes. The Make Your Dance Studio Thrive is a free webinar I'm doing with Miss Suzanne and myself on Thursday, October 17th at 10:30 a.m. Pacific time. And we're just going to chat about why attending a live event is important and share some insights on the class schedule. There's also going to be a great event called Denim and Diamonds, which is a private costume shopping event. Well, there's going to be cocktails and fun, looking at costumes. But really the best part is connecting with people who do what you do each day. So creating that community. I'm also doing another webinar on dancing holiday magic next week, October 18th at 9:30 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. And this is just talking about holiday choreography, how to make your holiday shows seamless and easy if this is something that you're doing this year.
Yeah, and I know you guys have at Tiffany's Dance Academy been doing some form of a holiday show, whether it's, you know, a Nutcracker Project or Swan Lake, or I know a few years ago when I was teaching at the studio, we did an outside kind of like free dancing holiday magic show. So what would you tell like a studio owner who's kind of like, okay, I didn't quite get to that this year, but it's at the top of my list for next year? What is the first thing that they would start with when they're trying to put a holiday show together?
Yeah, I think it can be as simple as, you know, getting choreography or creating it on your own, whichever you wanted to do, and teaching those in the classes and having maybe, oh, like the last week before the holiday, an in-studio observation or for the parents to come in at a party and show them the dances they're going to be doing. You can even have them dressing up in certain like flannels and, you know, like holiday style gear. And at that point, maybe announce that the following year, you're going to be taking your holiday dances onto a stage. So I think capitalizing on that time of year is really great and fun for your dancers and your families. And you'll find that your holiday show may become more popular even than your spring show. So it just kind of gives you in that mindset and also for your dancers in your studios. The other thing to work on now is if this is something you're going to do for the following year, for 2020, is to look for a venue. So this is a great time to do it because you can call and say, I'm looking for, you know, December 2020. What dates do you have available? So that gets you ahead of the game and you can start planning that for the next summer.
Yeah. And I think, you know, sometimes as a studio owner, everyone gets so busy. It's hard to really like narrow down, okay, what should I be focusing on? And I know the last two episodes, we talked about how recital, so getting your dancers on stage, and then revenue are kind of the two areas that you need to be focusing on in your business. So adding that holiday show is a great way to kind of hit two of those things, recital, because you're getting your dancers on stage two times a year, and then revenue, because you're going to be earning some additional revenue on ticket sales, costumes, and things like that. So let's go ahead. Now that we're kind of getting into fall, I know for myself, you know, living in the Midwest, the temperature starts dipping below 60 degrees and I switch to just like ordering everything online. So I'm Amazon priming like winter gear, ordering my groceries online. And I just have to say it's such an exciting time to be alive, which sounds really millennial of me, but there's just this technology.
Yes, it does.
There's technology now that's at our fingertips that just makes it a lot easier to kind of manage certain things in our life. And that's going to bring us to our first guest. Paul because he has some exciting technology that he's been working on for dance studio owners and parents. So Tiffany, do you want to go ahead and introduce Paul?
Yes, Paul is my husband and also the person in my life that has been creating systems that make my life easier and for all studio owners. And I'm really excited to introduce him today because I want him to talk about new technology that he's created called Nimbly Direct and Nimbly for Revolution. And he sees my struggle daily. I talk to him also about other studio owner friends that I have and their struggles. And then he works to solve those problems like any great husband would do. So I'm excited to have him on today to talk to everybody about what he's created and how it can help your studio.
Yeah. So welcome, Paul. How are you
Thanks
today,
for
Paul?
Having. I'm doing great. Thank you very much. I'm happy to be here.
I know we're no strangers to the innovation that happens at Revolution Dancewear. In fact, Tiffany did partner with them on the Curtsy Collection for Twinkle Star Dance, but we're really excited to hear about this new technology that's available to dance studio owners called Nimbly and its newest feature, Nimbly Direct. Paul, can you share just a little bit, maybe an introduction about what the two are for our listeners today?
Sure. Nimbly is a way for studio owners to create lists of products that they want their dancers to purchase through their online storefront, which is managed by the software. And you don't really have to do anything other than just assign costumes or products to lists and then tell dancers to go buy those products. And everything is handled by Revolution Dancewear, who fulfills those orders directly to the studio or to the consumer, whichever way you choose. And Nimbly Direct is this new thing that we built that's really cool. It's very exciting. And it allows studios to buy products at wholesale prices, but have those products delivered to the studio, labeled with the dancer name and boxed by class, so that it makes that distribution of products to dancers so easy. So that's what that is.
Yeah. And I think too, I'm sure our listeners are hearing like, oh my gosh, how amazing to have a package arrive from a costume company and have it labeled with the dancer's name and sorted by class. It almost sounds too good to be true. So I know Tiffany and Paul, you guys are, like Tiffany talked to in the beginning, really each other's biggest cheerleaders and sounding boards when it comes to business ideas, in particular kind of like focused on the studio. So can you share, Tiffany, how you guys came up with the concept for Nimbly Direct?
Yeah, I think Paul and I were sitting outside in the afternoon and we were talking about costume ordering and Nimbly and parents and recitals. And I was sharing with him a trend that I had been seeing, which was a troubling trend. The last 3 years, our Twinkle Star dance parents were not opting in or, you know, participating in our recitals. And we kept asking why, and it wasn't because it was too expensive or anything. They just didn't really see the need to do it, you know, or the value in it. They just didn't need to. And then we started wondering, well, maybe the process of having them buy their own costume online, maybe because now you can order your groceries just by looking at your phone and it sees your face, you know, maybe this is asking them to do too much. They don't, you know, everything's easier now. And gone are the days that they want all this information and want to control the process, I think. And so I said, you know, it'd be great actually if, because I'm obviously Nimbly, what that does is it allows us for when the costume comes in to have the dancer name sorted by the class, you know, all that stuff. And I don't want that to be, you know, gone. I want that to still happen. But what if we need to start charging our parents for the costumes and ordering on their behalf because they feel like they don't want to do that step? And so I said, you know, maybe we should do, or what do you think, Paul? Like, could we have a sort of a hybrid situation where we get the management part of Nimbly, but as a studio owner, I'm able to take out the work for the parent, order the costumes, but then, you know, on the end, the back end, when I receive them, then I don't have to do all that work of, you know, ordering, I'm not ordering, but sorting and receiving and, you know, giving them out. And he said, yeah, I think that would be a great idea. So he started working on that, and I'm sure there's so much more that goes into it than just my idea. It's so complicated, I would never know. But I can tell you that we went to to the process of saying, okay, opt out of our shows. So we're going to charge you on this day. And we really have had an increase, I don't know, 20-30% of participation in our recital. So it really, really did come down to the fact that they just didn't really want to do that extra step. So Nimbly Direct is really revolutionary and it's amazing. And I'm excited that Paul was able to take sort of, it was his idea as well. I mean, it was not just my idea. It was just, I saw that as a need and I saw it as a trend that maybe if I see it in California, maybe other studios would see it soon as well.
Yeah, can I add something? We had also talked about, you know, you mentioned how the enrollment in the, or the participation in the shows was going down. And we had also talked about how maybe we, as a studio, maybe it would be a good idea to offer this sort of VIP level of service to our customers, which is where they sign up for classes. And then since we have their credit card on file and they're being charged monthly for tuition, it isn't that big of a reach to say, hey, and by the way, here's your costume and here's your tickets to your show. And so it was all part about giving the customer what we thought they needed and to help us be more competitive with the other studios in our area. If we can provide something to them that gives them a huge value without them having to do anything, we just saw that as a huge benefit.
Yeah, and I think that's something, you know, you and Tiffany are really great as business owners at kind of looking at trends year to year and really adapting to what your customers need or what you're kind of foresee as like, okay, we're seeing a couple people in this area that are not doing the recital, not because, like Tiffany said, they can't afford it, but because they don't want to take the extra step or they're, you know, not clicking on that link in the email to purchase their costume in time and that sort of thing. So I think it's really smart that now other studio owners and stuff can kind of benefit from seeing what that trend is and then creating a technology system like Nimbly or Nimbly Direct where they can adapt to that change. Because I'm sure it's something that a lot of people are noticing in their studio, not just kind of, you know, in your seven dance studio locations.
Yeah. And I'd like to say also the other difficulty with ordering costumes, and this is the reason that Nimbly was built, the general Nimbly where parents can order, is that, you know, there's no system for managing what needs to be ordered. So, I mean, back in the old days, you know, we'd measure the dancer and I write down the measurements and then I would go and tally how many small child, how many medium child, how many, you know, and if you're using different costume companies, it might even be different types of sizes, you know, and so you'd have some sort of document somewhere that showed you how many of each style you need to order. And then you'd either call on the phone or now I think you can do it online and that's all great, but it doesn't attach a student name to that size. So it's very easy to make the mistake of ordering too many of one or not enough of another, just because it's just human error. And so what normal Nimbly solution there was that the parent could go order and then we know that they're placing an order on behalf of that student for that size. So it cut that out altogether. And that was a great solution until we realized, oh, wait, nobody now wants to go on and actually do this. We've made it too hard. So, but it still makes with Nimbly Direct, you know, your student names are in there in that class and you can go and you choose the size for each student. So it's a way for you to manage the actual ordering process as well. And I see that as being a huge benefit because there's a lot less errors in your ordering process.
Yeah, I think that's a great point. And I know that's something that, you know, as a consumer, Paul was kind of talking to me about how, you know, when someone is ordering a costume and then they have to exchange it for a different size or something like that, consumers nowadays, because a lot of stuff is ordered online, are used to that shipping being comped for them or something. I'm trying to figure out how to toss this to to you to talk about exchanges.
I can just say, as the person whose responsibility it has been over the last 20 years, well, maybe really 15 years, to make sure that the costumes are ordered correctly and received and sorted and distributed and handed out to each dancer, I can tell you that it's been my goal in life since I started building Costume Manager in 2006, I believe, to make that process easier. And it's evolved into this now very sophisticated system that allows Tiffany to use the Revolution and Curtsy and and Tenth House Brands to do all of her costumes for all of her shows. And when you have an enrollment of approaching 4,000 and you have 26 shows and you can still use one company's costumes, then you can really see that it's a huge benefit in terms of simplifying things, making it easier, and also being loyal to one company like that results in massive rebates and discounts and things like that that are available to people that are doing all their business with one company. So that's really important.
Yeah. And once upon a time, you know, we had a dancewear shop in each studio location. And also the thing that Nimbly does for us is it helps us deal with returns and exchanges that were, I mean, an unbelievable hassle at the very beginning. You know, when I was like a one woman show, it was like ordering, I had a call. And then when they came in and they didn't fit, then we had to charge the parent a certain amount of money because it was like $1,000 to return it or get a different, you know, size. And then we lose that customer because, you know, obviously over a costume. And I feel like Nimbly and Nimbly Direct have helped with that process. I know it's not 100%. I mean, obviously when things don't fit, you know, there's still an issue. I'm trying to get a new one, but maybe Paul, you can tell us a little bit about what happens through Nimbly or Nimbly Direct when a costume doesn't fit a dancer.
Yeah. And it's actually funny that you were talking about that because I remember back in the early days of owning our studio, maybe in the third or fourth year of owning it, we finished the season and we looked at we had an office manager that worked for us and we looked at her desk and there was a stack of, I guess they were like packing slips or something, that it was probably 3 inches thick on her desk. And what they were exchange forms. So they were actually orders where she had called up a company and said, hey, I need to exchange this costume for another costume. So the stack of papers on her desk was this enormous stack of hundreds of exchanges. And I was looking at them one day and I was like, did you realize that every time you place a replacement order with this company, they're charging you $15 per costume? And then we looked and said, is our policy that we're charging the customer for that? Because if we're getting charged $15 for every replacement costume we're doing, then we're just getting hammered. And we realized that we had lost thousands and thousands of dollars at that point. And that was the moment when I realized, wow, we have to fix this. We have to make it so that administrators that work for us aren't accidentally racking up these expenses that they don't really even realize or care about. And that's when I really started working on the problem. And I'm happy to say that we've gotten to the point now where Revolution is the first company that I know of in America that if you need to replace a costume, if you need to do an exchange and you have ordered your costumes on Nimbly via Nimbly Direct, or if your dancer has bought that costume on your storefront through Nimbly, an exchange can be initiated online without calling the customer service, and Revolution will send either the studio or the dancer a return label free of charge to get that costume shipped back to Revolution. And the replacement will come to the studio or to the dancer with no shipping charge. So when I say that you can finally have free exchanges on costumes, that's never happened in the dance industry before, that, as far as I know. And so that's a huge, huge thing. And also just in terms of being able to do it online, when you think about, I know that every major costume company that I know of makes you still call on the phone and talk to a customer service agent to initiate an RMA. And that's a long process that doesn't need to happen when we have all these tools at our fingertips to do it online. So we've made it super easy to get those replacements in free of charge.
Yeah, and that's really wonderful because, you know, as a studio owner, you're doing so many jobs every day. And when you have to be worried about one costume that needs to be exchanged or you're going to lose a student and you have to call in and, you know, you can lose dancers over a costume that doesn't fit and a costume company that is not working with you. So I feel like, you know, for that reason, you know, the only costume catalogs on my desk are Revolution and the new Curtsy costume collection for Twinkle Star Dance and also 10th House, because I know that I'm going to get good customer service, and they're on the side of the studio owner versus just being on the side of, you know, just being a company that, you know, sells things. I think it's really important. The costume company that you use understand what we go through, because, you know, we don't, the costumes are a necessary evil, right? We have to have them. We love them. They're cute. They're great. But really what we want is for the dancers to stay with us, you know, until they're 18 years old and dance with us and pay tuition. And so we don't want to lose them over something like a return. So that's really awesome to know that, you know, that that's their policy now. And so you can kind of rest easy if, if a parent is going, well, I don't know, did you order the right size? Or if you're ordering on your, on their behalf, then you can feel like, okay, it's not going to cost me an arm and a leg to get the better, to get the right size. Because that, that is the other reason we went to doing Nimbly and Costume Manager, was because, you know, we would guess the size based on the sizing chart, and it would come in and it wouldn't fit, and then it would be our fault and it was too expensive to exchange. So it's just really exciting to see 20 years later that we've solved these problems and we can focus on bigger and better things like teaching kids dance, you know, and managing our studios and our employees.
Yeah. And let me just add, you know, it's interesting what you said about what us studio owners want. And I can tell you, after having worked directly with Revolution for the last 3 years on this project, that I can tell you what they want. They want all of your business, and they want to do it, and they want to earn it by giving you tools to make your life easier. Obviously, the products are excellent. But what, and the way they do that is by giving you these massive rebates and discounts that we can talk about. And there's one in particular that's really important. The Nimbly Direct costs $4 per dancer to have your stuff delivered to your studio, labeled by dancer and packaged by class. That costs $4 per dancer, unless you are a member of their dance studio owner program, which I believe is it's a few hundred dollars a year. It's almost like a Costco business membership. Think of it that way. You become a member of this thing, and it has great content and all these other tools. But what it really does is it waives that Nimbly Direct fee of $4 per dancer, and it allows you to earn a rebate, a cash rebate, on all of your costume purchases throughout the whole year. And so you, once you become a member, you start earning a 10% rebate. And then when you hit $8,000, you go to 15% rebate. And if you're real big time and you hit $30,000, then you get a 20% rebate. And if you do $30,000 with a costume company, then you're going to get $6,000 cash back in a check in July. And that's really nice. That's very handy to have. Especially when summer rent is due in July and August. So that's been really helpful.
Yeah, and I'm glad that you guys are talking about how Revolution is there really as a partner and to support studio owners, because I know from attending Energize this summer, you know, that was kind of the message that they overwhelmingly tried to put into that weekend for the studio owners and the teachers there, was that we're here to support you. They want your business to grow and to flourish. You know, obviously, if you have more students in your studio, those students are ordering more dress code items and costumes and things like that. So it's kind of a win-win for them. And I think what's unique about working with Revolution is that they only are selling to dance studio owners. So they're not, you know, if you put a really cute costume on your Nimbly store or you're ordering it through Nimbly Direct, your parents can't log into Amazon or another like online market and see, oh, but that mouse costume, you know, retails here for $26, but you're charging me $36 or that sort of thing. So they really have a commitment to really supporting studio owners in their business, which is great to be partners with them through Twinkle Star Dance, because we know that they, you know, are on our, in our corner and really like rooting for us, which I think is important as well.
Yeah, and there's a really good example of how Tiffany's Dance Academy was the first customer of Nimbly Direct, obviously, because we were beta and testing it. But one of the really cool things that they did was Tiffany's Dance Academy likes to do these promotions to get new students to enroll. And a lot of times those promotions are something like enroll by October 30th and get a free tutu skirt or get a free pair of tights or get free dance shoes or something like that. And those are great promotions. They really do help increase enrollment, but it also creates an administrative headache for the studio, because now they have to actually order those products and receive them and figure out which dancers they go to. So Tiffany's did some promotions across all seven of their studios, and would the first Nimbly direct orders that came through were actually just dancewear. It was, I believe the promotion was a free tutu skirt and a pair of tights. And so when we saw these Nimbly direct orders coming in, it was, you know, 20 different dancers that had these items, and Revolution was able to ship those correctly in the right way, so that the studio, all they had to do was open up the box and read the dancer's name, and that's it. They just hand the product to the dancer. So that is like sort of like magic when you think of like, wow, all they really have to do is order this stuff and tell the shopping cart who it goes to and what class they're in, and then that's it. It's going to come ready to go. So that's a nice way to, if someone's thinking about using it and maybe wanting to test it out, then just try it. Try to do a little promotions, get some dancers enrolled, and then try to do a free leotard or something like that, and see how it's actually shipped and delivered to you.
Yeah, and Paul, so can you tell us how a studio can get started with Nimbly or Nimbly Direct? How do they sign up?
Yeah, it's real simple. You go to shopnimbly.com, and if you're already a Revolution customer, meaning you already have an account, there is a way for you to just complete a form. You just enter your account ID number. If you don't know it, it'll be emailed to you, and you put that account number into your ShopNimbly account, and it will create an account for you and ask you some questions of, do you want a store? Do you want Nimbly Direct? Do you want items to ship to your to the customer, or do you want them to ship to the studio? It just goes through the whole process for you. Probably takes about 5 minutes to set up an account. And then once you have your account, you're ready to go. You can either create lists of products that will show up on your store, or you could immediately look for a product, add it to your Nimbly Direct cart, tell the system what class it's for, and tell the system what dancers it's for, and place your order and check out just like you would on any e-commerce website. And then the next time you'll see those costumes is in your studio, labeled by dancer and boxed by class.
That's awesome. Well, I know, Paul, that I'm sure that people have follow-up questions or want to get in touch with you, especially, you know, because you have all these great technology, like consulting ideas and stuff in the works. How could someone reach out to you?
Best way to get me is through my email. It's phenderson@revolutiondance.com. If you're a customer that needs some help, you can call one of our, we have a dedicated account rep for Nimbly and Nimbly Direct. Her name is Kelly McNeff, and you can reach her at KMCNEFF@revolutiondance.com.
Awesome. Great. We're going to switch gears a little bit and talk about our Pinnacle Dance Conference and Retreat, which is coming up in July 2020. We're going to be at the Four Seasons Resort in Scottsdale, Arizona, and that's July 10th through the 12th. And I want to tell you guys something exciting. If you haven't purchased your tickets yet, we are doing a giveaway for early bird pricing on our attendee tickets on our Instagram account. It's super easy to enter. All you have to do is follow @TwinkleStarDance and @Pinnacle.DanceConference on Instagram. Like the post that's up there talking about it, and we want you to comment with a testimony either about attending one of our past conferences or live events, or about using the Twinkle Star program in your studio. And we're going to announce the winner once we hit 1,500 followers on the Twinkle Star Dance Instagram. So don't miss out on a great opportunity to get that early bird pricing. And if you want some more information, our new website should be live at pinnacledanceconference.com.